Hello friends, Heidi here from Rain Country. God is good all the time. And I thought it would be a good idea to show you how I do my budgeting every month and keep track of my bills and all that kind of stuff. Before I get started, I want to show you this. If you watched my garage sale videos from this last summer, these are the lights I got at that one garage sale, and I wasn't sure at first what I was going to do with them. And I don't remember what I paid for them. I got them really cheap. So these are LED lights, and they do actually just this set lights up the room beautifully. Of course, we have the overhead lights on for videos. That's pretty much the only reason we ever even use them. But when we had our Thanksgiving dinner in here, this made a really nice light, you know, it really lit up the dessert table. So anyway, I want to get started and show you what I have going on here and how I budget my money. And isn't this just a lovely countertop? I'm loving this countertop, all made by hand by Mr. Rain. Eventually I'll get a video out on that. It's just going to take me a long time because there's a lot involved in it. But anyway, this is all oak if you guys didn't know and you're new to our channel. Anyway, so what I have here is I print my bills off in increments of 4 per sheet. So each one of these stands for a whole month. And then what I do is I have, as you can see, I have all the different bills listed on this side of the piece of paper for the month. This is divided in half because I have to do a lot of erasing. And so this first part is, this is where I'm changing a lot and the paper gets a little wore out after a while. So then I do the last 2 weeks right here, and you can see there is a little bit of difference. So here are the bills. These are the amounts that the ones that are typed in are the ones that stay the same every month. And the spaces here are so I can write it in so I can change how much I'm paying. Because for example, our PUD bill, because we're mostly off-grid anyway, and we're already way ahead on our, we're about a year ahead on our PUD. This is Public Utilities District. And so sometimes I might not pay anything because we're so far ahead. And other times I might pay a little bit. Usually I'll try to just, you know, put a set amount and just always try to keep us that whole year ahead. In the water, I typically always pay $45 a month. And even though we have the rainwater collection, our water bill, it used to be, when we first moved in here, it was $25 a month. So this is how much the base fee has gone up since, our rates. So it's almost doubled. And this is us using rainwater for quite a bit of stuff, but at least in the summertime, because we use our rainwater for a lot of our garden, you know, for watering and stuff, our water bill doesn't go up like it used to in the summer months when we were doing a lot of watering. But anyway, right here, I could actually remove this now because Etsy is now taking their fees out as the money comes in. But it used to be at the beginning of every month I had to pay an Etsy fee in a lump sum. And those fees are the percentage that Etsy takes from our sales. And then every time I list an item, every single item, I have to pay 20 cents per item for a listing fee. And then there's other fees involved. So Etsy does actually get quite a bit of money from our, you know, from our store. But anyway, that's what this is here. Stamps, this is the stamps.com. This is where I get all my shipping from. And I usually just have put $100 in there because I'm always buying $100 at a time. And then I just leave it. I don't really ever scratch it out because sometimes I might have to buy that $100 worth of shipping twice in a week because we have so much stuff going through our store. I got fuel, I got money that will go into savings. Obviously, these are things that will change each month. Groceries, our Visa card, this is one that gets erased and changed quite a bit. And I do have Walmart because we do order some things from Walmart online, though we hardly ever go into the physical store. There are some things that we can get online delivered here. Like a lot of my fabrics come from either Walmart or Amazon. Those are the two main places my fabrics come from. And then Costco, even though we don't have a Costco card, we haven't had one in 3 years because we don't have a Costco near us. I do, again, just like with Walmart, like to order some things online. And then I have miscellaneous, and then I keep a space down here for any extra things that come up. Now you'll see in this list, you don't see anything about auto insurance or house insurance or even property taxes, because those are things that get paid once to twice a year. Because when you're paying, typically, when you're paying your auto insurance or your house insurance is once a year, auto insurance is twice, you will get a discount if you pay for the whole period all at once in one lump sum. You might save anywhere from $50 to $200 total by paying that, just getting it done. So down here in the space, if it's that month I'm going to pay any of those things, house insurance, auto insurance, or our property taxes, which are twice a year, then I will put that in here and then, you know, write that in here so I make sure. And then usually up here I will write the name of the month. See, obviously this one hasn't, I haven't filled it out at all because this is a fresh one. And so the month will go up here. And then on this side are the is the income that we have coming in. So we have, you know, what's already in our checking account, the little bit of money we make off of Amazon, the money we make off of Etsy, which is gets changed daily pretty much, and we get paid by the week through Etsy, YouTube, this is money we get from the kids because they're still on our insurance, our auto insurance, and then I total it up here, the total income, and then here in red is where I put the total of what the bills currently are, and then the balance that we have left over. So I don't use a checking, a ledger sheet like you get with your checkbook, because actually checks are something I hardly ever write, because I usually pay directly through the bank. But if I have any checks, those get written down here, and then I cross them off once I see them clear through the bank. So that's what happens here. Now, when I pay the bill, like most of our bills get paid online. And so once I've paid it, I'll put a little check mark next to it. And then once I see it clear, I completely scratch it off. Yeah, this is my subscribe and save. This is Amazon, because I'll have particular items that I like to buy monthly through Amazon, and that's a once a month thing. And then whatever that total is, I write that in here, and then once it's done and it's paid for, it gets scratched off. Now, I've talked before, and we each have our own cell phone, so that's why that's written like that, so I can cross one off, because they do at different times of the month. I cross one off once it comes through and is paid for, and then again with the second one. So going down to the Visa. So this is the one credit card we have, and we use our Visa. We actually make money off of our Visa. We never pay a cent in interest because we keep our Visa paid off. So whenever any of the, we use our Visa to pay for as many things as we can. You know, for Costco purchases, Amazon purchases, Walmart purchases, stamps, my shipping, anything like that. And then what happens is, I keep track right here of, I go in several times a week and make sure that I pay off the balance. And then I write that balance in here that I've paid. And then once that I see that clear the checking account, I erase that. And then maybe I'll write in a new one. And those different totals will come, like let's say I paid for a Walmart order, and I got it paid for on the Visa, that number will get transferred over here as the payment, and then this number will get erased. But I don't scratch these ones out because these are the ones that are constantly changing, same with the groceries, savings, fuel, but the ones like that are once a month, like PUD and water, subscribe and save, Netflix, and our CenturyLink, which is our internet, those will get scratched out completely. And yes, this is how high our internet is right now. Actually, it's a little bit higher because I always pay a little bit extra per month to stay ahead on it, just like I do with the PUD and the water. Anyway, and we have like the slowest internet in town, and we have the most expensive internet in town. So it's really silly, but it's all we can get, just so you understand how that works. But anyway, so then these numbers here will constantly be changed, and I can keep track of what's here. So one of the things I like to do with my balance, I always like to make sure that this balance is always going to be at least enough money, whatever's here, to cover another whole month's worth of bills. And I don't like it to go below that. and then all, any other money we might have will get, will come out and go into savings. And so that's how, you know, so we will keep putting that little bit away for buying property or whatever may come due. And yes, we are still looking at property. I have people asking us all the time, are we planning on moving, or what are we planning on doing? You know, things are still up in the air. We're getting a little more financially stable now, but, you know, again, we depend mostly on our Etsy stores. You know, I mentioned in a previous video, that is our number one source of income. And, you know, but we keep putting that money away for a property or as another form of a retirement plan if we decide to stay put. Things are still, we're still not certain. We do want property out of town. We want more privacy. We want more space. And yet we like what we've done here so far. And we want to stay close to our kids. And there are some benefits of being where we are. We're not far from the hospital if ever need be. We're just, you know, like I said, we're close to both of our kids this way. And when they start having kids of their own, then we're more local and they can bring the grandbabies by whenever. But anyway, that's where we are. That's a side topic. But I bring that up because, you know, that kind of plays into either way, we're still putting that money away. We're still looking at property, even if we just buy property to have it as an investment. That's the other thing that we're looking at. So anyway, that's how I keep track of my bills. And it's one of those things that I've done something similar to this since I was first out on my own. Actually, before I even left home and I was, you know, earning an income, I always kept track of what are my total bills, what do I have coming in, and then write them down and cross them off as they get paid so I never lose track or forget a bill that way. I'm always staying on top of things because, you know, it can happen. We can forget a bill, especially if it's something that's an odd bill that we don't get, such as property taxes or that twice a year insurance payment or the once a year house insurance and stuff like that. But as you can see, we have no house payments because we're completely out of debt. No car payments because, well, we're out of debt. So anyway, that's how I keep track of my bills. And I hope that you find this helpful and that it might help you in balancing your own checking account or savings account or whatever it is that you use. Okay, hope you enjoyed this video and that you learned something new. Thanks for watching. Take care and God bless.